Even the smallest thing sometimes means a big impact on the lives of someone who's going through a difficult period. The current installment of the 1776 Revolution Charity Program is Nate's Wish. Kids helping kids, families helping families, to know that they're not in this alone, to know that others have already been through this and that they can make it through.
I like to shoot bow and fish and play outside and stuff like that. I don't think they ever just said, you have cancer or whatever, but I mean, kind of slowly told me. I was 7, and yeah, it was scary, and I was upset and confused, trying to find the good and stuff, you know. Even though it's hard to, but you still can.
I was 9.99 years old. I still have 13 more weeks of chemo since leukemia. I had my life planned out of what I was going to do, and it just sort of changed everything. Some treatments are 6 months long, and if I were to stop at 6 months, it would be very likely that it would just come right back. I just keep in my head that it's going to be okay, that just to keep going, don't give up, because if I give up, I feel like I'll lose all my faith and I just basically fall apart.
My husband Jeff and I have 3 children, Nate, Allie, and Audrey. And our son Nate was diagnosed with cancer, with leukemia, when he was 5 years old. He had the chance to have a make-a-wish. What he chose was to have a basketball court.
When he would do hard things, a spinal tap, we would come back as soon as we rolled up in that driveway. He hit the basketball court and he would shoot 50 right-hand layups, 50 left-hand layups. He just focused on basketball. It was his way of keeping things in their place.
He passed while he was 7, not long before his 8th birthday. We had captured photos of things in his life after his diagnosis with cancer.
That's when he asked if he could have his own book. So the name is Nate's Story, What It's Like to Have Leukemia. It was a way of him sharing his story to help someone else. It's Nate sharing what he went through in his life with a child that's going through a very similar thing. We run a charity called Nate's Wish.
We started giving backpacks of gifts to children with cancer. That's lots of people that go into making Nate's Wish. We stuff all of the backpacks as full as we can make them with these cheerful, brightly colored pillowcases and these cozy socks. And lots of ladies will make the knotted blankets for us and pray over those. People that have made pillowcases prayed the whole time for the child that's going to lay their head on it.
As they pick out that fabric, they're thinking about the purpose of what it is to give some color in that room and some comfort. We do a lot of prayer when we choose what goes into the backpack. The backpack itself, we try to, you know, pick backpacks that have zippers that are easy to open and close. The iPads or iPod touches that have video capability for them to be able to communicate back to their families and friends. We did a lot of praying and trial and error of teddy bears that would go in the backpack. So we're really even specific about what teddy bear that is and how cuddly it is. And we picture that teddy bear going with them everywhere.
We have different people that make deliveries to the hospitals. Through our website, people can request backpacks for children at any children's hospital.
Something that's come about through Nate's Wish and the fundraising is kids helping kids. It is not just healthy kids bringing in their change, and the power in that transforming the lives of a child that is going through completely different things than cancer, but they're going through something. And them being able to help, it's powerful. So when we have a basketball tournament, one of the things we try to show those kids that are playing in that tournament that they're doing something they love and they're helping someone else. If you just let God use it, and He will. And He'll bless other people through your passion. That was Nate's wish.
It's not easy going through everything like this, but you have to look at the other side and realize that God's got this and you're going to get through it and it's going to be okay. You got this. God is here with you, and keep going. Kick cancer's butt.